they're going back to research.
Well, this group of investigators are piecing together the possible links, trying to determine what killed those four people. The Salisbury Police Department will send the marijuana from these most recent cases to the...
Hi, everybody. My name is Carolina Diamond. Welcome to my kitchen. Today, we'll be cooking some hamburger helper. A nice little small one-hit wonder dish when it's so hot. Right now in North Carolina, guys, it is a whopping 93 degrees. And so I decided to show you guys how to cook a small one-hit wonder dish that is so fast. You'd be like, oh my God, I'm so glad I'm done with dinner. Now I can sit down and rest because it's so hot. So these are the ingredients that we're going to need for this dinner tonight. As you guys can see, I already have my ground beef, hamburger helper, salt, pepper, onions, bell pepper. I have my Caesar salt, meat tenderizer, salt, and of course, the black pepper. So guys, this is what we're gonna do. First thing we're gonna do is go ahead and get our spatula. It doesn't have to be anything gigantic. You guys can use your iron skillet grill if you want to, or you can go ahead and use just what I'm about to use. It's just a regular skillet that I got from Walmart. It's pretty much the collection coming from Ozzy's, which is an organic cooker from Italy. So this is what I have right. I wish that I had a bigger spatula, but it's not going to be nobody but me and another guest for dinner tonight. So I'm going to cook small instead of big. I love to rinse out my spatula. I'll be right back, guys. I'm going to get a watch call. Basically, what I'm going to do is go ahead and wipe out my spatula. Go ahead and place it on the stove. In the meantime, guys, I'm going to go ahead and cut up my ingredients. And what you're basically going to do, I know some of you guys like a lot of meat into your hamburger helper. Some of you guys are on a diet, so go ahead and put your meat in at your discretion. But for me, I am going to use this little pot. You can get any bowl you want, but I just love to use a pot because it gets to the point. Me, I'm going to take... I'm going to use, as you can see, guys, this is a half a pound of ground beef. So instead of using the whole thing, I'm just going to use half of it, which would be 1/4 pound of ground beef. Because me, yeah, I'm on a diet, guys. I've already lost 10 pounds. Yay! I quit drinking alcohol, took all the sugar, and broke down my carbs down to great carbs that you need, you know, like... vegetables, that's green, and you know, salads and things of that nature. So what I'm gonna do now, guys, is go ahead and open up my ground beef, and it's already pre-washed, guys, and there's no blood or anything like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just get to it by opening it up. You guys can see what I'm doing. Just taking a knife, basically, just cut it up open. Very simple, to the point. You guys can season your food as you want to. Never, ever be afraid to season your food, because I was taught that's how you learn how to cook. And trust me, guys, when I started out at the age of, I guess I must have been like 11 or 12 when my mother allowed me to finally cook in the kitchen, it took a lot of practice for me to learn how to use salt and pepper. Lord, I used to not put enough salt in or put too much in it. But, you know, as you know, time progressed and I became a mother, now a grandma, thank you, Jesus, you just learn how to cook. So there you go, guys. I put half of that in there. So what I'm going to do now is go ahead and wrap this back up with some more plastic seal. You guys can use aluminum foil, whatever you like. For me, I like to just go ahead and use the plastic wrap. I'll just get to the point and, hey, keep getting the freezer burning. And then, you know, if I want to use it to make a little, you know, taco salad, etc., whatever I might, then, hey, I just pull it out, unthaw it, and just get to it. So I got that wrapped up. Yes. Yeah, I know some of you guys don't like that plastic wrap because sometimes the plastic wrap, it gets stuck around the spool. But if you just work with it, take your time with it, come out perfect, yo. And then you stop your meats or whatever you're wrapping up again. I mean, like, I'm getting freezer burn and stuff like that. But getting back to the ground beef, I am going to now, guys, go ahead and cut my onion up into four halves, because I'm not going to use that much onions. You know, some of you guys like onions. Me, I just like just a little bit, not too much. This is a good spring onion, y'all. I love spring onion. I love the way it smells. Oh, my God. It just brings out your food more than regular onions that, you know, people just use. There's some people just go grab an onion. I don't know what kind of onion it is. But me, I love spring onions. So what I'm going to do now, guys, is just go ahead and take these halves, put them in the refrigerator because I'm not going to need that much for me. Just go ahead and wrap them back up. And like this time, I love to use these little grocery bags, plastic bags, guys. They work wonders when you are in the kitchen and you don't have time to keep running towards the trash can. I like to put them right in the kitchen. I can just put all the things I want to throw away, you know, things that smell like, for example, tuna, onions or whatever, you know, onion peelings or whatever, into this trash. Or even just a little small little packaging that, you know, comes off, you know, the products that we buy from the grocery store. So what I'm going to do now, guys, is just take this 1/4 onion. I'm going to dice it up. As you can have you want to me, I don't have a chopping block because my chopping block has got old and you don't have to get another, but you know, there's always around things in the kitchen. So what I'm gonna do, guys, is just go ahead and take a regular flake. And you can see as I'm doing it. A regular flake, let me see if I can lower it down. And just pretty much dice up. My onions are small. Just put your onion, cut your onions the way you want to. With me, I like mine very fine and diced. So I'm just gonna cut them in small pieces. And a lot of people, you know, don't like cutting onions up because they say it make the eyes water. But I have a couple of things that, you know, my grandma and my mother tell me all the time, put a needle in your mouth or basically just go real fast and just get one of those pulverizers. You don't have to worry about it. But me, I have no problem with it because I love the smell of onions. Makes me think about a Coney Island hot dog, you know. So I'm going to go ahead and cut these up in small pieces, as you can see. No problem to me. I just love it. And I've never had a problem with my eyes watering with onions until, you know, I was a teenager. But my mom would have, and my or the whole family would cook for family reunions or church occasions where we had to sit there and cut onions up for days. I mean, God, we're cooking for 20 people or more. You'd be cutting onions all day long. So I'm going to go ahead and just chop them up real quick as I can just to go ahead and get this video done, guys, because I'm so excited to be cooking with you guys today. I know it's hot, so make sure that you drink plenty of water. And if you're going outside and the temperature's hot like mine here in the Carolinas when it's like a whopping 92 degrees right now, basically just make sure you put that sunscreen on. Make sure the SPF is 15 above so you don't get sunburned. And I don't care what anybody tell you, does not matter with the color of your skin, and you still get sunburned and still get skin cancer. So you have to be very, very careful when you go out there. And please, guys, drink lots of water. So I got that diced up pretty good. So I'm going to push that to the side, as you can see. Then I'm going to take this, my bell pepper. I love bell pepper. Wash it off. Guys and girls, please, honey. Well, ladies and gentlemen, because I know we all grown up in here. Please make sure you always wash your vegetables because you don't know who has been up when you go to the grocery store. I love washing my vegetables, honey. Okay, what nobody say. The best way to do is be safe and keep it clean. So I'm going to take this right, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up in the plastic, the plastic roll that I had before, which is nothing no more than plastic wrap. I'm just going to wrap that up and place that in the refrigerator. You know, a lot of people down here in North Carolina and South Carolina always say refrigerator. And that when I first moved here from New York, they call refrigerators cabinators. Lord bless my uncle, rest in peace. I have two uncles who love to call things like refrigerators cabinators, or, you know, call frigidaires, or, you know, things of that nature. And I think about them all the time, though they, you know, gone and moved on and gone home to glory to God or whatever the case may be. It just makes me laugh because I remember I used to laugh about it all the time and be like, what you laughing at, girl? That's the way we talk down here. Like, and I just remember those good times. And then, you know, my granddad or the whole family get together and, you know, kill a hog or whatever down here in the country. And I was like, oh, my God, you know, how can they do that? But one thing I realized is that It ain't nothing like family. Family that prays together, cooks together, they stay together. You know, it's just family values that you learn as a kid that you never thought, oh, when I get old, I'll never do that. But you know what? Good habits always fall on you, honey. I don't care where you come from or who you are. If you've been taught something that's very valuable to you, please, honey, always pass it down. Because I tell you what, good always outweighs anything's bad. And cooking with your family, honey, and having a good time sitting down and, you know, growing as a family by eating together, priceless. So what I'm going to do now, guys, is go ahead and pour the onions and the bell pepper inside the ground beef right here now. Yes, now it looks so good. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to put my spatula or my pan on a very low medium 7. Place this in the kitchen sink. Watch. Guys, I forgot to put my onions up. I don't know why I forgot that. I guess I got so excited talking about, you know, when I was a little girl growing up, how I learned how to cook and how our family down here in the Carolinas, we just love to cook and have parties, get-togethers, church functions. And I'm basically just putting these onions, y'all, these spring onions inside a plastic wrap. You put it back in the refrigerator. I can use it for future use. And so always keep your vegetables fresh, guys. We have a pulse. So the next thing I'm going to do, guys, is go ahead and I'm going to turn up a little bit because it's getting a little hot in here, guys, because I'm trying to sit down and enjoy the nice cool fan. You know, I just realized my mom might be coming over. So instead of me just putting that half a pack of ground beef, I'm going to go ahead and put the other half in there. And then, and guess what? You have leftover for tomorrow. We got to worry about cooking, you know? Yes. When heat like this, when it is here in the South, y'all, I'm telling you right now, the best thing that you can do is cook leftovers and enjoy them because it is too hot to be cooking every day. Y'all feel me? I love to cook, but honey, I love to stay cool, too. But anyway, I put the rest of that half in there. I'm going to throw it away in my little trash bag right here. I'm going to show you guys in a minute. Just want to get the food on because it is 5:30. I usually like to try to cook by 5, but I'm running a little late today. So what I'm going to do now is go ahead and churn them. You guys can see what I'm doing. Just churning up the onions and the ground beef. So that being said, okay, now I'm going to add my seasoning. I thought I wash my hands. I'm going to go ahead and add just a sprinkle of seasoned salt. You can use it at your discretion. I just bought this today at Piggly Wiggly, guys. I got a great deal on it, 2 for $2. And I was like, yeah, I'm glad I'm here. So I'm just basically just taking off the protective sealant that I bought that's on the seasoning. And I'm going to go ahead and, while I'm doing that, go ahead and season seasoned salt just a little bit, not too much, y'all. Y'all can do how y'all want to, but me, I don't need that much seasoned salt, just enough to wake up the flavor. So I'm gonna put that on my seasoning rack over here. You guys can't see, my seasoning rack is right here. But getting back to the meal, I'm gonna go ahead and add some meat tenderizer. I gotta do the same thing I did before because both of these bottles just came from the grocery store. So just go ahead and unwind it. It off. There we go. Then the very next thing I'm going to do is sprinkle a little bit on there. Not too much, but just enough to wake it up. I say about a half, maybe probably not even a half a tablespoon. So, definitely over there. I've got my onions going on. Next thing I'm going to add is a little bit some black pepper. Love me some pepper. All on top. Achoo! Excuse me, y'all. Excuse me. I know that pepper do to you.
Make it sneeze.
Excuse me. Okay, then the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and add some salt. I just bought some new salt today, but I do have an old box of salt over here that I'm trying to use before I throw it away. I don't put very much salt in my food. I really don't. Just a dash to wake it up, and pretty much I let the guests or whoever I'm eating dinner with add their own salt because I don't like too much salt, but other people in my family, they just love to put a lot of salt on their food. And what I'm going to do now is continue to grind it up. Just grind it up. Make sure all the ingredients is ground up together. And push that to the side. And then the very next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and add it to the spatula. Can y'all see me at the stove right here? I'm going to try to pull it up where you guys can see. Okay, so I'm going to place it in the spatula, which I already told you is already on a medium 7. So it should be ready for a brownie. Oh, yeah. It smells oh so good. I'm going to show you guys. I'm just going to put all this over in here. I got my bell peppers, my onions, my seasoning and everything in there. I'm going to let that cook for about 15 minutes. Put this in the sink. So, now for you youngsters that need to know how to cook, always make sure that you got a parent in the kitchen with you so you know what you can do. Have mom and dad or whoever that's watching over you show you how to read this and go exactly by this. But me, I am a little bit more advanced. I've been cooking for over 30 years. I want to tell my age, but it is what else. Thank God for my age, of every age I have. But I put ground beef, I put onions, I put bell peppers in mine, and I put seasoning salt. But as you can see right here, it says cook up to, I need my glasses to, I guess, 8 to 9 minutes, brown it or whatever, and you drain it. Me, I like to cook mine. I put a double portion in here, so I'm going to cook mine for about 10 minutes, and then after that, you cook some more, then you add your ingredients, but I'm going to show y'all a different twist. Y'all can always read the box, but I'm going to show you my way. So I'm going to let that cook, and go ahead and place a lid over my spatula, but I like to go ahead and speed it up, and what it does, when you put a lid on your food, it seals in all the steam and the flavor, so that when your meat comes out, and you add it to the contents or whatever you like. For me, this is, I'm going to use my hamburger helper. It makes the meat just boom. I mean, it just tastes oh so good. So, but while we're doing that, I'm going to go ahead and put my vegetables on, which is going to be a can of sweet potato. No, not sweet potatoes. Let's try some. Sweet corn. And normally I would have my own way. You know, you just peel it and you pull the shuck off and you just cut it up. But, you know, with the heat and with the truck driving, we could not find fresh ear corn, so I had to go and get the can of corn, but no problem. Thank God we got some corn. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and open this up. I can find my can opener. Okay, it's in the sink. It's in the, that's right. I'm going to go ahead and open it up. I'm just going to put one can inside of a saucepan and cook it about 15 to about 20 minutes. Add a little bit of butter to it, salt, pepper, add what you like, but that's what I'm going to add, and you know, have that for a little bit of vegetable, and I'm going to make a salad. And that's going to be dinner for tonight. So basically, I open that up, then it's simply wash. Open that up. Now I got to find me a sauce pot. Oh God, I gotta get low. Oh my God, I hate it when my pots all the way back here. My knees are, just had knee surgery about 3 weeks ago. They're still tender. Well, not 3 weeks ago, about 9 weeks ago. I'm out of cash now, about 3 weeks. And my knee is still tender. So, oh no. I got it really hurt to get this one. Only because I love y'all. Oh, Jesus. Pray for me, y'all. I'm still healing. Okay, got it. All right, got it. Ooh, it took me a while to get that, didn't it? So what I'm going to do is go ahead and rinse this out. I don't know, just something I learned from my mom. Let's go ahead and rinse it out, dry it out. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is go ahead and add the corn to the pot. And a lot of times, my grandmother, what she used to do is she didn't like using the water out of the cans or whatever. She would take it, and pretty much she never really used canned foods, but she had to because she was tired or whatever. She would just drain all the water out from whatever the was in the comments, she put her own spring water in it. You know, some things that different cooks do, but me, I just go ahead and just throw it in there. And I put some butter in there, some salt and pepper. Like that. I know about this. You know, you cook yourself like you guys want to. Just some things I've learned coming from the people that I loved growing up as a kid. So, next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get a new knife. And one thing about me, y'all, if y'all notice when I cook, I'm always saying the utensils, throw them in the sink, and then I rewash them instead of using the same one. I don't know. It's just something that I've always done as a kid. But what I'm going to do now is put about 2 tablespoons of butter inside my my corn. And if you guys don't know how to determine how much 2 tablespoons of butter is on a stick of butter, all you got to do is look at the side. You see the little, let me see if I can make it clear for you guys. The little lines between that, that means 1 tablespoon, 2 tablespoons. So that is approximately 2 tablespoons. So what I'm going to do right now is just go ahead and throw that in the pot for my corn. Throw this butter wrapper away in my little bag over here. Let me show you guys what I'm talking about when I say little bag. Y'all see that? I like to use one of those right there to basically put my little trash in, and I can just tie it up and throw it in the main trash. So, but anyway, guys, I'm going to put that in there. And while that's going, I'm going to go ahead and wash my dishes. Put them up first and wash my dishes. Casserole bowl. I cooked a wonderful cheeseburger macaroni casserole last night, and it was slamming, y'all. Slamming so much, I didn't get a chance to eat it. My brothers came up here and just tore it up. I'm putting on the dishes now. Y'all give me just a minute. We're going to get back to this cookie because I'm ready to sit down. And I love to put my major cooking utensils over here to the side. I'm going to close that up, put the bowl up here. And of course, I cooked a good cheesecake pie last night. It was gone. You see, it's gone. But I love to keep those aluminum pans just for, you know, if you want to just take some meat or whatever and just put it inside the refrigerator because, you know, you just want to just keep it for leftovers. It's a good thing I put aluminum foil on it and it does the job, y'all. So now what I'm going to do now is go ahead and turn my corn on a medium 6. Let it go ahead and marinate. Sit there for a little while, and then in about 5 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and put my seasoning, which is basically a little bit of parsley, and I like salt and pepper, and just let it go for what it does, okay? But getting back to the washing these dishes, y'all, I gotta tell you, I love to have a clean kitchen. I cannot, will not cook in a dirty kitchen. I mean, you know, everybody got their little perks in mind. I just love to be clean. I think cleanliness next to godliness, and then, you know, people come to your house and like, oh gosh, this cooker, this kitchen clean. We're just gonna stay here. I'm just joking. I'm just a clean person. Homeboy, I was raised in military, so. But anyway, getting back to this food. Go ahead and put my water in here. Now it's about time to get some more done. I have another bottle back there in my utility room. Utility closet, well, utility laundry room, in other words. Everybody pronounce things differently. I'm no different. Oh my God, it is so hot, guys. Oh my God, I'm so glad. Now it's getting cloudy outside. I love it's getting ready to rain. So that is great to me. I love that. Turn that down just a little bit. Oh God, y'all, that ground beef is smelling so good. Just gonna, trying to give it time to brown up. Clean things up a little bit. Ready time to go ahead and knock it out. Guys, I thought about ending this video to make it more professional, but this is my first recorded video in a long time. So I'm not gonna edit this one. I'm gonna upload it because I'm trying to test out this new software that I have on my computer for recording movies. And I want to see it in entirety. So, but when you see this video in the playback, please guys, give me your advice. I can make my channel better because, you know, I decided to change if you guys like the name. And I love other people's advice, especially for you guys have been around me since I've been on YouTube. I value advice. I'm thinking about changing my channel name to Carolina Diamonds Diner and drop the production. Or what do you guys just think is cooking? Just keep it as Carolina Diamond Productions. So I'll put that in the description or maybe put it on my community tab. So I can truly get you guys a spin it. Let me turn that down because it's on a high 7. I want to cook that fast. So I turn it on a 4 for now because I'm washing dishes. So I'm going to go ahead and clean, rinse these off and put it in the dish rack. We get back to our cooking. Yeah, I have lost some weight. Y'all guys can see my little traps coming in. I've been working out, y'all. And I, if you know, guys, I'm going to tell you the best thing I think I've ever done, and I feel so great. I am on my 7th day of sobriety. Can you guys believe that? No alcohol. Carolina Diamond has not drank alcohol in 7 days. And I'll tell you what, I feel good, too. I really do. I have not been, I ain't never been a real bad drunk, let's put it that way. I just can't handle my alcohol like some of you guys can, but I have not been sobriety free from alcohol since I was 18. It feels great. And I mean, I get it because I guess when my aunt passed away and I looked at my video, I was like, oh my God, that is the wrong way to, what I'm doing now, guys, breaking out the meat. I turned it down a little bit. Yes. I turned it down a little bit and I'm just breaking it up so I can put it inside the hamburger helper. I'm just going to let it brown up, and then I'm going to drain it, and then I like to go ahead and put it inside the hamburger helper. So I'm basically just going ahead and cut it up until it's brown. You guys, I'm going to show you in just a minute what's going on here. I turned this thing down. I swear it seems like it's still got a mind of its own. And it's old, too, y'all. Y'all see how red it is? It's probably about time to replace this stove, I guess. I don't know. But I turned that sucker down, honey. I'll continue to break up the ground beef. And oh God, these onions smell so good. And the bell peppers. And pretty much it's not going to take that long the way this thing is aging. I don't understand. I tell y'all, I got my thing on too. And you see how red it is? I don't understand that. That's kind of scary to me. I want to watch my meat. I really do. I want my meat to cook too quick. So let's put this thing down on simmer and see what happens. But I'm going to take my spoon. I usually have a fork, but I'm putting it on the dish rack. And I'm going to put it back. I'm going to lay it back on it and let it do its thing. But I'm watching this because I'm thinking about switching eyes, guys, because I don't know what's going on. But to me, it seems like it's about time to, I don't know, take it out and see what's going on. But right now, I just turned my corn. I realized I didn't have it on. I'm going to find a lid and a fork. I tell you, it is hot. One thing I hate is coming to the kitchen when it's hot. I hate it. Y'all see how much, I promise y'all, look. This thing is on two. Y'all see that? It's on two right there. And look at it. Ain't that crazy? But anyway, y'all. I think what I'm going to do is switch eyes. I can't stand that. I hate that. I got to see what's going on with this bad boy. There we go. Okay, now it's doing like it's broken. Now we've got corn going on. We got this on a medium 6 back here. Let it catch up with the food. So, let it put it about 7 so it can catch up with the meat. But the meat was cooking at a fast rate, but I had to turn it off, then turn it back on because I realized what was wrong with it. And basically, I think it's about time to replace the eye on the stove. So, but in the meantime, while that's going on, I'm going to go ahead and make my salad. And then by the time that happens, we can go ahead and cook the hamburger helper. And guys, I'm also adding some extra to it. It's going to be 3 types of cheese. I like to use cheddar cheese, Swiss cheese, and mozzarella cheese on top. And it's just so good. That was just my little recipe. So in the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and get out the ingredients for the salad. Guys, what I'm going to do is find something to put the salad in. And me, I love these little pots I bought from Walmart. A lot of people think we just use a pot just for cooking in. No, I would use mine to make salads in too, also. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and get out me some American fresh, fresh crunchy blend. And what it has is iceberg, Romanian lettuce, and it has carrots, red cabbage, and radishes, which is very good for your your digestive bowel. It's good probiotics, and it's also good for your diet. Oh my God, I love salads. I can eat salads for every day if I could. Today's just gonna be basically a chef salad. I'm just gonna add turkey, cheese, tomatoes, cucumbers, you know, that little type of thing, just for a little side salad, because like I told you guys, I am really into exercising and loving my results. Even though I spent 35 years in the military with 34 plus one with the late entry program, but I spent that many times in the military. But honey, when you call yourself retired, you realize like, I ain't got to do this stuff no more. And you know how to do it, you just get so lazy. I'm just speaking for me, because I can't speak for anybody else, but you know how to do it. But once you get back into it, you're like, yeah, I should have did this a long time ago. Yeah, I got on the scale that said 140. I was like, what? I was so happy. But anyway, enough of that. The next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and get my meat, which is glazed turkey. Y'all never tried glazed turkey. It is very good. I learned how to eat some of that in Germany. My best tour, I'm telling you. Go to your local dairy, and it is the best thing ever. It is good for, you know, when you're not trying to, when you're trying not to eat the pork and you want to change your diet, get the glazed turkey. Very good. And it smells oh so sweet. What I'm going to do is go ahead and cut these in little small pieces, because it's not a real gigantic salad. It's just pretty much for me, you know, because I love to eat salads. Like when I get tired and don't want to cook and I don't feel like eating my leftovers, I have my salad, y'all, really. And what I'm doing is taking these little turkey pieces, cut them in half. I mean, we'll actually pull them apart, you know, instead of me just cutting them up, just give me time to sit back and enjoy some of this cool air, because it is hot. Okay. I'm going to get another. Maybe one more slice. Why not? I think I'll just cut the whole pack. Cut the whole pack up. Pull them apart. And I'm putting this little package inside my little bag on the side over here. So I'm intending to break the turkey apart. Dinner is going to be slamming, y'all. And it's 5:45, so hopefully I'll be eating by 6:15. So I'm going to take that, go ahead and stir it up a little bit. Then the next thing I'm going to do is get my tomatoes and cucumber. And cheese. Okay. So, you see, I got the cucumbers, tomatoes, and I got my mild cheddar cheese, and I'm going to also add some cheddar and some mozzarella cheese to it. And then also, I'm going to add those three same cheese inside the my hamburger helper. So, but I'm going to go ahead and while I'm doing that, I'm going to go ahead and chop up my meat again and make sure that it is red. All the redness is gone on the inside. And it's looking good, y'all. Okay. All right. Sounds, smells good, y'all. Woo-wee! I'm going to show y'all what that meat looks like. Okay, go ahead and turn it off. Man, I tell you, it is amazing. Show y'all what that meat look like. Y'all see that? Wow, that looks great, doesn't it? So what I'm going to do, guys, normally people like to sit there and they drain their stuff their type of way, but me, I love to do my little thing. And basically, instead of me cooking inside of a spatula, I'm just going to go ahead and cook it inside of a pot, which is more easier for me. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take my pot out and take the meat. Let's put this salad to the side, because I got to get this hamburger helper going on, and we'll finish the salad as it starts. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to take a pancake. You can call it a pancake scoop, but I like to call it a scooper. What I just basically do is move my spoon, put it to the side, take my scooper to drain the meat, to completely drain the meat. Y'all see what I'm doing? And I place all my meat inside the pot. Just drain it. Make sure you get drain all that, that grease out of there, honey. I like to call it my manual George Foreman.
If it makes any sense.
Okay. Wow. And it's okay if you drop a little pig's head. It's all right. We all make mistakes, right? Nobody ain't perfect. So I'm going to continue to drain off. See, I'm still dropping the meat. Thank God for clean stove. And go ahead and drain the meat. Sometimes you got to use little fingers to get all that extra meat out of there. And there we go with that. So I'm going to place this to the side because I don't need that anymore. And the oil, what I'm going to do is put it inside the stove because all I want to do is cool off so when I do get ready to dispose of the grease, it won't be so hot, it won't burn me. So while that's going on, I like to put that inside so that it cool down a little bit so it wouldn't mess up my drain or burn me or, you know, so I don't make just, so I won't make a mess and hurt myself. How about that? So just let it cool off. So now, what we're going to do is, y'all give me just a second. I'm going to reach in here and get my ingredient that I really do need. Right back. So the next thing I'm going to do is I cook my ground beef and I'm ground it. What I'm doing now is stir in the hot water, milk, some sauce mix and pasta. And basically what I'm adding now is I'm going to need 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil, which is already in the meat. I don't put the extra oil in my stuff. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take 1 quarter of hot water and 2 cups of milk, 1 tablespoon of margarine. So this is what I'm going to do, guys. Instead of me doing hot water, what I'll do is, y'all see I got my glasses on. Like I said, around the kitchen, I need to start wearing my glasses. But see, I'm gonna add about 1 1/4 of water. This is about 1 1/2 cup. So what I'll do is actually it's 2 cups. What I'm gonna do is put a half, about right there. Y'all see what I'm saying? So I'll take that, put it in the microwave for about 1 minute. You guys can do it your way, you know, but me, I like to do it this way so we can cut down time because who has time to boil some water just to put some dog on put it on some hamburger helper. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do it, guys, go ahead and open this box up. You can read the directions for a simple way to do hamburger helper. Or you know if you are you guys have been cooking for a long time like I have, you do your own ingredients. But this is how I'm doing mine. I am just gonna basically just take this all out. Oh God, I could get better open the box, huh? I cut my nails off, so it feels like throw this away. Drop the little noodle. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and place all the Chewy Ranch burger, that's what it's called. Put all the pasta inside here. That right there. And then the next thing I'm gonna do is take the hot water out that I got boiling over here. Hot. And what I'm going to do is basically just pour it over the pasta and the meat. And since it's just boiled, I'll put that back into the dish rack. And then the next thing I'm going to do is get out and get me 2 cups of milk. So I got to use that cup again. Instead of me using whole milk, guys, I like to use 2% reduced fat milk. Because like I said, I'm on a diet. You can use your whole milk, skim milk, any kind of milk you want. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and fill up this cup because it's equivalent to 2 cups. And I definitely got to make sure I put more milk on my grocery list. I love milk. Love it. What I'm going to do next is go ahead and place my milk inside the pasta and the meat. And I'm gonna put that in the dishwater. Place that stove on a 7. And I'm gonna give me some butter, margarine, 2 tablespoons, I think it's called for. Well, you guys, you don't have to go by directions of what it says on the box. I'm gonna put 1 tablespoon, or you can cook your food the way you see fit. Like if you're on a diet, you don't have to put the whole all the ingredients in there. You can cut some ingredients down, you know, cut back on calorie intake. But me, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut the As long as I have two tablespoons, I'm just going to put one tablespoon. Because I don't need all that butter. That means there's more time on the treadmill, more time running. Since I can't run, Lord, I hate working on the treadmill right now. Can't wait till I start running again. So, yeah, guys, you don't know what a tablespoon looks like. It, like I told you before, it's right there. That's one tablespoon. You can see where the lines are by is one tablespoon. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and cut. And that's why I love to freeze my butter because it is so easy to cut. And you can just put it back in the freezer. I love keeping my butter in my freezer. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and place that in here. And after that, I'm going to go ahead and add the cheese sauce. Cheese sauce comes in there. It's called ranchy cheese ranch. It's supposed to be great, guys. I can't wait to try this recipe. I never tried cheese ranch. I always get cheeseburger. Let's try something different. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in there. Okay. Put all my ingredients that I trashed inside my little plastic bag here on the side. Put that over there inside the dishwasher. So dishwater so I can wash it. Y'all hear me? I keep saying dishwasher. I'm so used to having a dishwasher, but when I came home to the country, man, it's a total new thing. Now, what I'm going to do is go ahead and turn this up a little higher. Go ahead and wash my lid because it goes to this pot as well. I just scratched. This one thing I love about going to Walmart and get you some new dishes. They got the little pot lids that go with the pans. You don't have to spend so much money, you know? These times, you know, with gas being so high and, you know, everything's high. Milk 20% up, rent 40% up. I mean, God, you got to learn how to save money some type of way. So I'm going to just go ahead and wipe this off. And place the lid on to the pot and let the ingredients go ahead and boil up a little bit. And then I'm going to stir it up. Wipe down my counter. While we're doing that, I'm going to go ahead and wash my dishes over here. I just like to go ahead and knock things out because, you know, when you get rid of dinner, all you got to do is wash your plate and sit down and enjoy yourself because most of your dishes you mess up while preparing dinner is already cooking. So that being said, put that in there. That air dry. Let's put it back into my cooking utensil. And you know what? A lot of people don't understand it. Never ever, if you can try, don't put your knife over like that. You can hurt yourself. Just put it face down. Just always keep safe. But I tell you, my mom and my grandma, they're always bad about throwing their knives out. And when we were little kids, we were like, stay out the kitchen. How about they know exactly who got in trouble? Because the person that used to get in trouble in the kitchen, get the sugar with grandma and granddaddy, or mama said, stay out the kitchen, then cut themselves because they had the knives straight up. So I know who did it. Come on in here. Get this bad ass out. Get smack that booty. That's how they always catch us. I'm going to push this back on the back eye, y'all. This eye right here gets a little too hot, so I'm going to push that back some. And turn this up on a 7. And now, next thing I'm going to do now is we'll finish the salad. First of all, I better check on this corn, y'all. I forgot all about it. Not really, but I was just sitting there putting it on the low back burner because I'd like to put my corn to come out. I like my food to come out. Done around the same time, you know? So right now, I'm going to get a spoon and basically stir it around. I still got some utensils I got to wash. I'm going to pull out so many out of the utensils over there. Go ahead and rinse it off. I'm going to come over here and stir my corn. That butter smells so good. So this time, y'all, I'm going to go ahead and season up my corn with some salt. Put as much as you want to me. I probably put about a half a teaspoon of salt in my food. Not much. And I let the person who's eating season their own food because, you know, we all got different levels of salt and, you know, seasoning that we like in our food. And same thing with black pepper. I just put a dash in it. And then let it go for what it does. And I'm going to go ahead and place this on a low 6 so it can go ahead and, you know, catch up. And by the time the hamburger helper is done, we'll be ready to go too. But in the meantime, while that's going on, I'm going to go ahead and stir this up as well. Make sure all the ingredients are stirring up good because it's beginning to melt and it's smelling good already. Oh my God, this is gonna be gone, y'all. He's not very well. What I'm gonna do, guys, because I got too much in the open, I'm gonna dial it with a little bit of water. You guys have been cooking a long time. You know when and what to add to your food to make it better. I mean, I had a little bit of water because I didn't want all that extra milk, and I want to break some of that fat up. I have some of the calories in it, and make it plus it makes it still come out pretty golden color. So now getting back to the salad, y'all. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and wash off my cucumber and go ahead and peel my stuff. Let me see if I can turn everything down. I want my everything is good. It needs to be. All right. Make sure my food is down. Okay, it's on everything I need to be on the bright settings. I can take these glasses off now because I'm not gonna read anything. All right. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and wash my cucumbers, make sure it's properly washed. Like I said, guys, always wash your meat, wash your food, wash your vegetables, anything you get from the grocery store, because you know, no man's been out. And what I'm basically doing now, guys, go ahead and peel in the cucumbers. Some people don't like to peel their cucumbers. They like to go ahead and cut them up. I mean, because, you know, a lot of, like they said, a lot of vitamins and all the good ingredients are inside the skin of a vegetable or a fruit. But me, I like to go ahead and cut them up because I just like cucumbers without the skin on them. And sometimes I like to cut them up real fine and put them in some vinegar and salt. Oh, my God, you have got yourself a great snack when you're trying to watch your weight, or you ain't got to be watching your weight, it's still just a good snack, you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and just cut this all up. I'm just gonna do one, guys, because it's not, I don't need to put all that cucumbers in a three serving salad. So I'm trying to go ahead and cut all that up. Okay. I know somebody called me, y'all. I can feel it already. And I'm going live. I do what I got to do, then I call people, unless it's an emergency. If it's an emergency, they call me on my house. When my house won't ring, but I can see my cell phone just going off. And that's what I'm doing now. I'm trying to speed up the process. Now, I don't want to cut my hands because this knife is very sharp. So you guys can see I'm pretty much cutting up the cucumbers, trying to get the rest of the grain off. Okay. So, as you can see, that looks good. I'm going to wash it again. And I'm going to go ahead and put all my peelings inside this bag over here. You guys can see why it's so convenient. When I'm done cooking, what I'm going to do with it, you're like, oh my God, I should thought of that myself. And I got this little trick from one of the sergeant majors when I go over their house. I watch them. You know what? I should do that myself instead of running to the trash can all the time. So, what I'm going to do now is go ahead and cut up the cucumbers. Cut them as thick as you want. Me, I like mine to be small. So, that's a lot of cucumber. That's a large cucumber. So, do all of that. Yeah, I have homework tonight, so that's why I'm uploading this video tonight. Because I said, I'm going to cook. I promised everybody I was going to cook. I haven't cooked in a while. I said, let's go ahead and make dinner. Something fast and something easy. But something enjoyable, you know? When it's too hot outside, you don't feel like cooking. But you're like, oh God, let me go ahead and cook for two days. I don't have to cook tomorrow because it's so hot. So that's what I'm doing right now. So right now, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get my tomato. Wash it off. Please wash it off. And y'all, please, look at it. I know I used to do this all the time when I first got married. I got married young and divorced young. I would always leave this plastic on. I was like, oh my God. But now, you know, after you've been married and you know, had your kids and growing up, you always remember the little things that used to be your eras when you learn how to cook. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this up. It's like real small pieces, dice up the tomatoes. You can cut yours the way you want to. And me, I like to go ahead and cut them in holes and cut them in fours. I'm going to show you guys in a minute what I'm talking about. I am just trying to go ahead and cut them on the side over here so I can speed up the process. I can sit down and enjoy the cool air. So I'm just going to cover up a whole tomatoes and just slice them. So you want as thick as you want to. I like to cut mine really thin. But I'm not going to cut too much thin because I don't want to cut myself. But this is a knife has been sharpened from yesterday, and it's real sharp. And then when I get to right here, guys, guess what I do? Throw it away. So I'm going to do it right now. What I'm going to do right now, guys, you see these tomatoes right here? I'm just going to cut them in fours. You cut them yours as small as you like. But me, I like to cut them in fours. Yep. I don't have a chopping block, so I got all this on a plate right now. And I'm just going to throw it in the pot. Okay. Oh, man, guess what I heard last night? R. Kelly got 30 years in prison, guys. I was like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, I thought maybe, you know, if he was going to get prison time, I didn't think it was going to be that long because he's a superstar and all the things they're saying about him, I don't know if it's true or not. And he raped these little girls or whatever. You know, I love R. Kelly's music. I hope that he didn't, but if he did, oh my God, bro. I mean, you got time to think about it, but if you didn't do it, I pray for you, but if you did, bro, you got to do your time because you don't, when you become a superstar, you don't have to do all that. I'm not saying you did, but everybody said you did. So I don't know. But allegedly, when all these things were happening, I was defending the country somewhere else. So what I'm going to do, guys, go ahead and continue to cut up these little pieces of tomatoes. And they're done. So in there, the next thing I'm going to do is add the cheese. I'll check on this hamburger helper, see what's going on with it, and it's doing oh so well. Stirring it up. What we do now is go ahead and turn it down in a low 7 and let it continue to cook about 15 more minutes. And look, y'all, this is what I love to eat. Like when you cook a couple eggs in the morning, or you're pretty much trying to get your protein in and, you know, less sugary and less carbs. I always save extra eggs just in case if I want to make a salad. I love to put egg whites inside my salad because it just brings out a flavor. And sometimes I wish I could eat the egg yolk, but the egg yolk is what got all of the high cholesterol and the calories, something that I don't need because I'm trying to watch my body fat and I am weight training now. So, but anyway, I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and crack up the egg. And I'm going to cut it into small pieces after I take the yolk out. Now, you guys might want the yolk in your stuff, but me? No, not for me. And Lord, Thanksgiving time and all that, I will have to have the yolk in my salad. I love it. I love it. You know, even though after the egg is dried up, what I'm about to do is go ahead and put more water on it. And what it does, it loosens up the shell so it'd be easy to peel. But I've heard a lot of my friends on YouTube and even the girls I know say to put some salt in your eggs while they're boiling. And it makes so much easier for the shell to come off. And I didn't know that. And I never tried it, but I think next time I will. Just see how it goes and I can tell you about it. I'm sure it works. A lot of people said that, so I just never tried it. What I'm continuing to do is go ahead and peel this egg. They got these new containers now, guys, where you just can basically take your egg and put it inside of a container. You don't even have to worry about shedding or peeling eggs. I never tried that. So if you guys ever tried it before, can you put in the comments how it turned out? Because I would think about getting it. Because my biggest pet peeve, I hate peeling eggs. I do. You got to take time and patience. If you're just impatient, you'll mess it up. But me, I've learned. I just hate it. I hate it. I don't know why. I guess, you know, helping my aunts and my mother cook for Thanksgiving dinners, etc. I just hated it. Because I wanted to go outside and be with my friends, but I couldn't do anything until my chores were done. And my biggest pet peeve is always like, man, screw the egg. My mom used to get so mad at me because I'm peeling right. Like, go on outside. I just hated it. I did. So what I'm doing right now, guys, is going to rinse off my egg because I don't like no shells in my egg. No, no, no. Can't do it. And what I'm going to do next is make sure it's off. That is... Y'all hear the gas? They say the gas is going to go down. Listen to the news in the background. I'll see it when I believe it. Every time they tell us, that gas is gonna go down here in North Carolina, South Carolina, it goes up. So what I'm doing now is, you guys can see, I'm taking out the egg white, the egg yolk. And normally I would go ahead and put them to the side and make some deviled eggs, but not today.
Can't eat deviled eggs.
Oh God, I wish I could though. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and take the other half of this egg and take the yolk out, because I'm going here. They're talking about rain. I hope we do get some rain today. Today is the day of my daughter's birthday. Y'all look at my community tab, because I am going to upload this video tonight. Make sure you guys get it before 9 o'clock, so you can enjoy, you know, test out the recipe and see how you like it. You can try it, share that with your family. You know, it's a quick way to cook dinner when you ain't trying to stay in the kitchen so long. But, you know, me, since I'm talking, uploading the video, I'm not going to even edit it. Let you guys see what I do in the kitchen. And then after that, I'll promise you, my next time I upload my cooking videos, and be a little bit more professional and to the point. All right, but this is my first one, because like I told you guys, I am changing my name from Carolina Diamond Productions to Carolina Diners and More. Or somebody, just keep it Carolina Diner Productions, then we know you're CDP. If you guys think I should change my channel name to Carolina Diamond Diner, let me know in the comment. Or should I keep it Carolina Diamond Productions? Because they said productions cover everything Carolina. I was like, all right, whatever. I said, I'll take a vote. But anyway, getting back to the salad. I'm going to stir up the hamburger helper, guys. And ladies and gentlemen, guys, please excuse me saying guys, because I'm so used to saying that, meaning everybody. I said, you know what? Let me address people who they are. Ladies and gentlemen. So what I'm going to do now is continue to stir that up. I let that simmer a little bit more, because I think it needs about 10 more minutes. And my corn smells so good. I am just going to add a little bit more water to it. Let it go for about 10 more minutes. And we hope we'll be eating about 15 minutes from now. Okay. Now, as there goes. Put that cup back in here because it's still playing. Okay. So we're gonna let that boil for about 10 minutes, and the hamburger for about another 10 minutes also. All right. Now, next thing we're gonna sell, y'all, we're gonna put some cheese in. I've been, recording for 57 minutes. Can y'all believe that? I thought something was gonna take about 35 minutes. It actually turned into an hour. So what I'm gonna do now, you guys, you know, you gotta cut. You can actually pull it to the side. Put some of this cheese in here. Instead of me putting three cheese, I think I'm going to put one cheese today, which is going to be mild cheddar. I am supposed to be watching my freaking all those cheese. Lord, I'm wasting calories, right? Not burning off the calories enough. So I'm going to put about a half a cup of cheese in it. Maybe a little bit more. There we go. So about a half a cup of cheese. Close that back up. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and stir all the ingredients around. You guys can see it in just a minute. I'm going to turn the light on so you guys can see everything. Excuse my kitchen. But as you can see, I'm getting the salad. I've got cucumbers. I've got egg whites. I have glazed turkey. I have carrots. I have lettuce, romaine lettuce. I have parsley, and pretty much add a little bit of salt, just a little bit of salt, a little black pepper. Usually I have accent, y'all, but today I don't have accent because I'm getting at the market. So I'm just gonna use traditional black pepper and salt and a little bit of parsley, just to wake up the flavor of my salad. Just a little bit, a little black pepper on my vegetables. Just a little bit of salt. Just a little bit of salt. Well, it comes out. There we go. Just a little bit of salt. And what I'm going to do is take this plate, go ahead and put it in the refrigerator. And by the time dinner gets started, it's time to serve me. And I need to check my phone, y'all. Yeah.
Okay. Now. Okay, what I'm doing now, everybody, is checking my phone
because I know I heard it go off. And the reason why I do it is because sometimes I have some of my friends who subscribe to my channel call me and ask me questions or pretty much just checking on me. And right now I do have a message from a very important person. It says, check out your Twitter. Oh my God, I got a couple messages there, but anyway, it's all good. Check out open positions for job resume. But anyway, cool. Nobody's really called. Let me see. Did I miss a call from anybody? No. Great. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and stir up this a little bit more, y'all. Turn it down a little bit. It's about there. Check on the corn. Corn is great. I'm going to put a little bit more salt in it because I did add a little bit more water to it, just a little bit. So, go ahead and add it like that. And stir it up very well. Okay. Corn is good to go. Let's turn it off. Let's keep it on real well until my hamburger helper is done. Which I've never seen anybody cook hamburger helper in a pot before, huh? Well, honey, I am the one to do that. What I'm going to do is check on the tenders of my macaroni or the extra pasta. You have a pasta cooker, and I love to cook my pasta in a pasta cooker. Because for some reason, you ain't got to worry about tasting it when you just cook it on a certain amount of time. About 5 more minutes. Y'all, it's so good. I better quit. I got 2 of these little noodles here. When they slam, I'm going to spoil my dinner. Okay. I'm going to continue to just go ahead and wash dishes. Give about 5 more minutes. We'll give about 10 more minutes. I like my pasta on just right. And I didn't have it on that high. I did that on a very low medium. About a 5 or 6. I was telling you guys about, it got really red hot. I think it pretty much burned out because I've had this stove now a very long time. And I think it's about time to go and get another stove. Which is no problem because I'm in the process of getting new furniture. I finally found out the furniture, guys, I really want for my living room. And I found it, and I'm going to go ahead and get it on my birthday. And so she getting the furniture for her birthday. What in the world? Yeah, because I pretty much got everything I need, you know? So let me give me some, buy myself some furniture. I know my kids would have bought it or somebody that's in my family. I was like, no, I'm going to get it myself. Yeah. You guys, I'm going to tell y'all something somebody don't ever tell y'all. If y'all think retired veterans are millionaires, y'all are sadly mistaken. We don't make that much money. We made enough to take care of it. Depending on how many years you spend in the military and retire as, we make enough to take care of ourselves, but it's nothing compared to what we used to have when we were in the military. But if you clear the popular belief, a lot of people think we get medical, dental, and all that stuff. Honey, I'm telling you something, when it comes to dental, you don't get dental unless you're 100% disabled. I have to pay for my dental. And I was looking at YouTube and a couple more, New York Times, just looking at some things on the internet. And it's a doggone shame that people that's risked their lives for 20 years, and just anybody who joins the military, I don't care how long you're staying there, you got to pay for dental. Uncle Sam, y'all need to get y'all shit together, because I remember a time when I was in the military, a young little E-67, when I could see my supervisor and their wives and their kids go to the dentist on post or whatever and get treated for dental. How come we can't get that now? And we got time to risk our lives and to make sure that, you know, America stays secure. Don't you think when we come out that we should have security when it comes to our dental? Come on, y'all. Think about that. It was up to me and I was president. No service member pay taxes or have to worry about dental or medical. You know? That's something that's given when you get out. But anyway, that's just my opinion. Alrighty. Y'all smelling oh so good. Y'all look how much weight I've lost. Oh my God, I am so proud of myself. I remember I was drinking so much, y'all. I had two of these things going on. And you know, basically what I did, I took all the alcohol, took out sugar. I took out complex carbs, meaning rice and, you know, potatoes, and started eating more vegetables, drinking more water, staying away from sodas, drinking more herbal teas and walking. Yeah, I remember when I took my cast off, it was so hard for me to walk up the stairs. Do y'all realize I can walk a mile now after physical therapy? Physical therapy is so demanding. Sometimes I cry, but I look at where I've been 3 weeks ago when I took out that cast, and now, honey, you give me 6 more weeks, I'll probably be walking, running. Running, running, running. I just cannot wait. And y'all get up early in the morning by around 4:30, and, you know, I don't want to, but I say, you know what, I got to do this for me, for my daughters, so I can live a long time with my grandkids, because I want to be 1 million years old when God calls me home, you know, because I know we all got to leave here one day. But keeping it one, I want to live as long as I can, honey, because I love my family. And but when my time comes, I'm going to have like 25,000 generations. Like, you know what, she was a good woman, she's a good mom, she's a good person, period. That's how I want to go out, you know what I mean? And so in order for me to do that, I had to cut some things out of my life, like one, the drinking, two, get back to the basics, you know, get up early, having something to do every morning. Because, you know, when you retire, you're like, screw it. I'm not going to rely on a alarm clock. I'm going to get up whenever I want to. And, you know, you spend years in the Army like I have, or, you know, just even you've been in the Army 3 or 4 years. You're so used to getting up at 5:30, 4:45 every morning. Me, I wake up at 4:45, but you know what I do? I look at that clock and turn right back over. Now, at 4:45, I'm up, flexing, stretching, ready to hit outside or whatever my workout is going to be, pumping iron, all that stuff. Y'all see them guns coming in there? What? It was flabby, y'all, about 3 weeks ago. And I'm like, wow. And I tried to do some push-ups. Oh, my God. I remember when I was in the Army, I used to do like 70 push-ups in 2 minutes. Honey, I'd give myself 50 tests. I couldn't do 25. But now, I can do 40. So sometimes you got to know, even though you know how to do it, you may be a professional athlete, may have an injury, or you may even be a personal trainer who hasn't been in a long time. If you have not taken care of your body and you know how to do it, I send a challenge out to you, get back to it. Because I'm telling you, the first week or so is going to be hard, but when that third week come around, you're like, oh my God, going back to the basics, I can do this. And I promise y'all, by August 15th, all this thing going to be done with a six pack. And this booty going to be trouble like it's high, but right now it might be jangling, but it's gonna be ching ching. All these lunges and stuff I'm doing, and it hurts my knee, so I can't go, I can't bend too far, but I go where I can just feel it, like, you know, just hold it. Yeah, you know, working it out. But y'all, getting back to the food, because we about to eat, y'all, you know what I mean? So I'm gonna show y'all exactly what this looks like. I'm gonna put this lid inside of the sink. I love doing this so I don't burn myself, and then, you know, all that oil and all the water that comes off of it doesn't drain onto my sink or onto myself. So this is what I'm going to do, guys. I'm going to stir it up a little bit because it is ready. Ready. I'm going to go ahead and turn it off because it's good to go. I am going to show you guys what it's like. I'm going to eat a little sample, and then I'm going to let you go, and I hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, you'd like to see more content like this, like, subscribe, share me out, leave me a comment, give me a thumbs up. Well, you know, I can say correct criticism, too. Just leave it in the comment. Let me know what you think about it. Good, the bad. Yeah, I love to take it all because some folks can't take correct criticism. I can. I love it. I love everybody's opinion. And I do read my comments, y'all. I try to answer all of them, even though some YouTubers, when they get past a certain number, they like start hitting that little button. No, I'm going to answer all of my comments. I love it. Even if it's bad, you know, I still answer. Thank you for what you said, but I know you may not agree. It's such, you know, to some that know, because I think even sometimes when people put comments on your videos and they may seem negative to you,
Maybe they don't know what you're not reading it from their level. So answer it back, you know, as best as you can. That's what I'm saying. So I'm going to go ahead and get me some corn over here. Y'all, I eat in fist-sized portions. I don't count calories. I just look at my portions. Portion ratio and rate ratio, which is a fist size. Go ahead and put that back on there. Make sure my stove is off. And now, what I'm going to do now, y'all, is get my salad. I'm trying to find me a fork, but I got to open this drawer and it's stuck. No problem. Okay, I got my pork. I'm gonna go ahead and get my salad. You guys see what's going on here. All right. I know I'm gonna have my camera, my tripod, behind this up in the back. That's why I cook. I said, man, I'm gonna miss out so I can sit down and eat, y'all. So right now I'm gonna get my salad. Getting out my trusty salad. Spatula. What I'm gonna do, y'all, oh God, this is gonna be great for me. I love cooking and eating good, y'all. Eating good, wholesome food that's good for your health. That's good for the soul. And I'm gonna put a portion of my salad there. I try to make it look cute, y'all, but today I am hungry. So y'all bear with me for a minute. I'm gonna go ahead and put this back in the refrigerator. And my choice of dressing is gonna be Italian dressing. Believe it or not, Italian dressing is probably the best dressing because it's not condensed as like things like ranch and Thousand Islands. So it's less in calorie. The thinner your dressing is, the better it is for you, okay? So now I'm gonna go ahead and get my Thousand Islands. I wish I did Italian dressing. I love Thousand Islands. I wish I could have some, but not for the next 6 weeks. So I'm going to put a little bit of that, just a teaspoon, not a teaspoon, but less than about a tablespoon. And that. Y'all start getting calories behind that, and those, the calories and the fat intake on those labels. I don't always read it, but when it says fat, more than 6 grams of fat in a dressing salad, I don't need it. But some of them has up to 28 grams of fat in it. And all them sit-ups you're doing, honey, you ain't doing it. Wasting your time. You're going to use all that. And some of y'all don't know the difference between tablespoons and 6 tablespoons. I go to the buffet sometimes. I'm on a diet, girl. Girl, I'm going to put about 6 doggone bottles of $1,000 on a little salad. And I wonder why she can't lose weight. I'm not a health nut, y'all, but I just know how to do it, how to lose weight, you know. Some of them say I'm tall, man. I love doing it. Okay. Now, I had to put that drawer back in there, y'all, because it did get stuck. I had to put a little bit of oil on it. Let me wash my hands, y'all. I'm going to test out the food. And my choice of drink today is going to be water. I love water. Actually, I got a Diet Coke over here. Y'all, I really got this new application that I'm recording my video on. I hope it comes out right. I am, because I would be so mad if I... cooking in this kitchen for 1 hour and one hour 13 minutes don't come out right. Well, y'all, to test out the food, I got my little Pepsi over here. I'm gonna go ahead and sample it for you, show you guys how good it is. I got my corn right here. Bon appetit, baby. Slamming. Y'all, I got me that's good. I can taste the great butter in it. Not too subtle, but just right. And then I have my hamburger helper here with my ingredients in it. Y'all, this is so good. I gotta pop my stomach, but that is good, y'all. Get a little bit of salad right here. Y'all know it's the bomb. I love salads.
Mm-mm-mm. Y'all, this is the best diet dinner that I've cooked in a long time. Cucumbers is good. Like I said, it's the vinegar from Italia. The corn is on point. Oh my God. And you notice I have no bread, y'all. No bread. And that's all right with me. And this Diet Coke. Wow, it's right on time. Thank you guys for watching me cook. It's been very real. This is Play on the Playback. And please believe me, y'all. No editing is going to be done on this one because it's going to be my first video for Carolina Diamonds Diner. But remember, y'all, if y'all want me to keep Carolina Diamond Productions, tell me in the comments, or should I change it to Carolina Diamonds Diner? I think the production does sound better because I guess I had the name so long, but just the diner, just give me a true niche. You guys know I'm going to be cooking something and we're going to be talking about something. But so give me what your opinion, because your opinion, I definitely value your opinion, okay? So until then, guys, much love. See you on the next dinner, y'all. Peace.